3/4 of an hour, you're up and you can see, you can go to the Tate, you can go to the National Gallery, you can see those things, you know, you can, and then you can step out of the line. It's wild here, you know, as well, compared to East Sussex. I tell you, is anyone doing East Sussex? Yeah. It's, you know, that's a very, very suburban landscape, which is why I sort of ended up in suburbia, you know, because that's probably where I'm from. But out here, you know, oh, it's wild, not wild like when you found, you know, but, or the Isle of Shepherd, but it's out here. And it's very landscape, and this flatness of planet. Now, the reason I'm going on about this is because all of you, most of you standing in here, have an association with Kent. Some of you are older, most of you younger, and you will remember that Kent is now part of your existence. It's part of your A to Z. And it's etched on your memory. Now, here's another connection with printing, is that you remember seeing. You've seen 30,000 things today. You probably saw 2,000 things coming from the west of your world to here. But certain things you remember. If I say, tell me two things that happened this year, those things etch themselves very, very slightly on your brain and stay in there. And all the other stuff gets kind of forgotten. And that is almost like this wonderful printing process. So, Canterbury is an East Kent of etched itself in my psyche. And what I love about the curation and the idea of this show is that it says, we are going to bring some people together who've had this common experience. Now, one day there will be a method, a needle, or, you know, if you hold up a CD or a, what is that? You know, probably Segovia in there, but you don't know by looking at it. You need a player to play, or an LP, you need a needle. But these words, one day there will be a needle which you will be able to play and find out what, you know, that sound, that smell will come out of you, some common experience. And the fact is that the Kentish people who had an association, have produced this work. Now, when I was at Canterbury Art School, one of the exciting things as well about, we were stuck out here on the limb, and you're still out here on the limb, that's what it is, but people used to arrive with packs of new motorcycles, and they were going abroad. We had a student from Canterbury Alps or Italy, a place that we'd never been to in those days. It just looked very, very exciting. The redolent promise. Now, of course, we're in the generation that, have, you know, we now go everywhere. So, Prague, the weekend of 1999. You know. And so, art has changed, and exhibitions have changed, and the groupings of exhibitions have curated, sort of started in the 1980s. You know, they see an artist in Prague and they think, wow, hey, that, you know. And so suddenly you've got exhibitions which are full of people who made wonderful things. And but we're beginning to lose touch because they're people from different parts of the world. And the curators are saying, you know, I've been on more planes than you have. Yeah, I've got people who you certainly won't understand. You know, it's because I'm groovy, you know, and I've got all these foreign artists, I've got ours. And you think, well, here we are. Well, is that it's, I don't know, it's a national level, but it kind of is from this sect of art. And it's a pretty good team to put together. And I will just say one final thing, it is beautifully put together. It's a very, very nice hand. Lovely to see all those things placed. I can remember those woodcuts. He was beginning those when I used to play in Kilburn the High Roads, and we went down to try and borrow 200 quid for the Women PA. And he was wearing glasses for the first time, and he was suddenly a bit older because he had been the younger man, and he could just do these little woodcuts. And, you know, we were contributing to the sound as well, you know, caravan and soft machine and all those sorts of things. You know, Kent, that's it. That's what it, you know, it is. And I look over here and I see Tracey Emin looking so, I mean, I can't really, I can't see with my, but I can see enough to see how well she goes and frame up that touch.
Hi.
Terrific wall. It's a serious, serious wall. Almost as good as this. Anyway, without further ado, I would like to congratulate Martin and Michael and Alan and Kiki, all the students including Dr. Thomas, for running this course, and hearing and recognising that rebel in the world going to do a modern art show with living artists, and I can tell you they are hell. They're much safer than dead. I do declare this terrific Krikey Contemporary Prints exhibition